when I was a young man, I make a cabinet in 3 weeks. And now I'm an old man, it takes me 3 months. So, the eyes are a little dim sometimes, and hands are a little more shaking, but still I enjoy it.
How much time have you so far spent in this cabinet?
Oh, I don't know, quite a bit. And it will be maybe finished, maybe February, March. It all depends how much I work in it. The router mark is here, see? And that has to be done. That makes it all even with all the whole bundle. And now you have to blend it down that it disappears, see? See? And this is the form of a Renaissance molding. Out of the books about furniture making. You cannot make a design for yourself, you have to follow what a book said about Renaissance. See? A nice and round, see? With a couple strokes of this plane and that plane. Nice, yeah.
It's perfect.
Say something. It has to go here, you see, and then it has to be, you go small piece around here with a miter on it. And then a piece in around here. It has to be glued on. Years ago, when they built these cabinets, they put nails in it, and each nail has a little square, little block in it.
And it has to be glued. There are end grains, and that end grain, this glue, sinks in faster than in a vertical grain.
So not too much glue?
Well, lots of glue, but not on the bottom.
Four is enough. It is done now. So, see now you can see that's closed with this block here. Here. And that's closed. Other way. That's soft wood and that's hard wood. And the blocks has to be soft, other way you get a mark in a hard wood. That's oak and that's pine.
Oak? No, oak wood is that is the style of oak, that is Renaissance style. And they have lots of oak. Yeah, you have to know lots of geometry in furniture making, all right. And then you make a line here and there and that cross each other there. And then you put a paper on it and that is, you cut, then you start cutting. Thank you.
very nice. See? See that? Sorry. Mm-hmm. See that? This part of the circle is smaller than here. The shaft is wider and smaller here. You can do it also with a scrape blade, and the file is easier, see? Isn't that nice? No, number two.
Exactly 6, 7, 6. You turn at 7, 6, 7 centimeters, 6 millimeters, and then the sanding takes off in 0.5 millimeter. See? Very careful. It takes quite a while. Die is scherp.
Oké.
Zie je wel dat er niet zoveel af hoeft? De edging. Ja. Zie je wel dat ik een halve hals ben?
Ja.
Yeah, that has to be exactly. So, yeah, nice, very good.
No, it is, I would say perfect. There's the same width, that collar here, and a column. That's a little wider here, and it is deep enough, good, and that is the biggest on the bottom. See? And you can see that there's nice proportion. See? That's, see here the circle, and here a circle, and there a circle, see? But first, it has to, the column will be here underneath, see? So. So, and then here the ebony band around here. No, I don't need him as of a mallet to make marks in it. The wood would break it. It's too fragile. That job and it would break. So we have to do mostly with a hand. See? No, there we are. Nice. That's the frame for the door. See? It is level. It is square. The second bit is good. Of course it is good. So, this is a closed joint. See, the joints in fine cabinet work cannot be used without that miter block. Here, now we routed it here. It has to be routed out now that it is left over. See, like that here.
Yeah, nice. Huh?
It looks good.
Yeah. Yes, that is when that's molding making. See? And that will be here in a mitron here. And that will be A. See, when that fits that. So prima.
Shrink or not?
Oh yeah.
Wood always shrinks?
Yeah, shrink to swell.
So these are the glue blocks, Herman?
Yeah. In a furniture making is that important, clamps and a good grinding stone. Nou, moet eens kijken zo mooi dat erin past.
Perfect fit.
Hè?
Perfect fit, ja.
Zo, nou klaar. So that, see? It's reset. Here will be the wood carving. Here the knob. And here will be the wood carving. All around like that. That has to be laid out and marked here. As it breaks here, the grain is going. You have always to think about the grain of the wood. See? See, it breaks over here. It has to break here. That's all right. Now you have to cut it like that. Here. See? Very careful here. See, this is the depth thing. See? Makes scratches, so.
And you take out the scratches and then you have the same depth. See? So. This cabinet, it is Renaissance. I like that, see? But what I said, it is all lots of work and lots of patience. But I'm very satisfied with it so far. I save all the soft wood for wood carving most. Give it.
So this is a long process, huh?
Yeah. See? Support the chisel. It's hard wood. It's not too hard. It's soft oak. So, bottom parts are done. Now we have to put, make the top pieces. And then the top pieces are done. Now we have to make a circle here for the knob. And if we can dig it out like that, a little deep it out, see? That the edge is coming a little forward like a leaf. Well, we use it for tippling. It has to be made yourself. You can buy it in the store. It was not too bad, that last piece here. That was a long, took a long time.
Oh, those claws.
At last, claws, yeah. At last, it was done. Ah, wonderful it looks. If you'd have not had the courage to go through the process, you know, you can better go fishing. Well, yeah. It looks good. I like it. I like it myself. I make ones in cabinet that was wider. That is 1.50 meters and that other one was 1.75 meters. No, that's the story.